the last two games of the season. Not so much to play for Dynamo Zurich, survive relegation. How are you approaching the final phase of the season?
Yes, Dynamo, we always play to win. And we have an obligation to our fans to make sure that we maintain standards. And playing at a high level, we respect Mtare City, but we should be gunning for 3 points.
And obviously, when you came into this job, the mandate was very clear: help Dynamo survive relegation, and that you have done. How do you feel as a coach, probably after helping a team like Dynamo to survive relegation?
I would want first to thank the board and the executive for having the trust in me at that critical juncture, the way it was sink or swim. It means there was a lot of faith for them to give me the mandate to try to save the team. I would also want to appreciate the support I've received from my mates in the technical team, the manager, the medical team, my son and assistant, Rabi Mrabi. And I want to appreciate the response we got from the boys when we demanded that we must win at all costs. I'm obviously satisfied that we've achieved our objective, and I can sleep easy without any pressure.
And no chance for complacency?
We want to have the 12th man always behind us, now and tomorrow. So once we show them that we can be reckless in our approach, then we can lose the 12th man. So for them, we must play.
And when you say Mrabi, you mentioned him as your son. What exactly do you mean by that?
Mrabi, I've coached him. I'm the one who coached him in the provincial squad, the under-17. I'm the one who took him to the under-17 national team. And he was part of the squad that I qualified with and under Stephen Kwashi for the first Africa Youth Championship in 1997. So to me, he's like my son. So I hear some people say, yeah, Mrabi is the one who... No. When I'm with him, I'm also developing him as a coach. A lot of trust in him. I give him instructions to stand up and give instructions. Also, I analyze the game. To me, there is nothing that is out of order. It is out of trust. And I have faith in him that he is going to develop into a good coach.
And obviously, you are now planning with the next season in mind. I saw a lot of youngsters today training.
Yeah. You know that the greater part of my life I've mixed competitive football and development. And we have identified quite a number of youngsters. We have just seen only a glimpse of the youngsters that might be coming in. Whether I'm given the job or not, but we must recruit quality at Dynamo.
Possibly any injury updates, coach?
Yeah, it's unfortunate we have lost Kanondro. I don't think he will recover in time for him to fulfill these two last games because of the shoulder injury he picked in the Chibugu Super Cup semi-final match against Triangle. It seems that the shoulder injury continues to nag him. So definitely he'll be out for this weekend. And quality Kangas, those two definitely. With Kapuburika and Blessing Moyo, we'll do our final assessment tomorrow. But there is a possibility those can be included.
But still, do you think you have enough material to fill those gaps?
If we could play with 13 infield players against Triangle, I think when we've got 16, it's a better proposition than having painting. So under the circumstances, I think we'll be able to commit.
And the military is in opposition. How do you see that?
You see, when a team has nothing to lose, they can become very dangerous, and when they are very desperate. So we prepare thoroughly and expect anything. We expect a determined military united, and that is what we are drumming into the heads of our players. We will not allow complacence to creep in.
And obviously, this is going to be your last game at home. What do you promise your fans?
That will deliver the 3 points to them, hopefully with a little bit of flair.
Thank you so much, coach.